Here's the latest on xtox.com. An FDA advisory panel is strongly recommending that the agency approve Celltrion's biosimilar of Johnson & Johnson's Remicade. What would the approval mean for sales of the inflammation drug? Hello, I'm Sarah Massey, life science blogger and webinar moderator for xtox.com, and welcome to this edition of xtox Vitals. The South Korea-based Celltrion is working with Pfizer to secure the FDA's approval for the drug on the U.S. market. The FDA has called Remsima, Celltrion's name for the biosimilar, highly similar to the original version of the drug created by Johnson & Johnson. Across three clinical trials, the FDA found no clinically meaningful differences between the branded drug and the biosimilar. Following last year's $17 billion acquisition of Hospira, Pfizer gained marketing rights to Remsima, which is already approved in Europe. Celltrion, in conjunction with Pfizer, is looking to gain regulatory approval for all of the drug's proposed indications, which include rheumatoid arthritis, Crohn's disease, and psoriasis. So far, the biosimilar has only been shown to be comparable to Remicade in the treatment of two types of arthritis. However, the FDA may permit Remsima to be approved for the same conditions as the branded version, even though the biosimilar has not been tested for them. While the report is welcome news to Celltrion and Pfizer, Johnson & Johnson is already feeling the heat from Remsima in the European market, where it's slowly gaining market share. As Remicade generates billions for Johnson & Johnson in the U.S., Celltrion's Remsima could represent major competition for the drug maker if it gains approval. Subscribe to the xtox YouTube channel by clicking the subscribe button below, and visit xtox.com for more information on this story and other news stories in the life science industry.